A lady. The Rolls Royce of ladies, Aunt Christine.
So, Christine, for you, it is the wonderful Bette Midler from the film Beaches, Wind Beneath My Wings. I'm getting tongue-tied from...
Right.
Go on, Simon, you do it better.
It's Wind Beneath My Wings, going out there to the lovely Christine, and enjoy the track. Midler with Wing Beneath My Wings, going out there to the lovely one and only star of the show, Christine.
I hope you like that one, Christine.
Yes.
And I said at the start last one, hard rock. Well, we're moving on to a bit of hard rock now. At the time when this was recorded, well, it was the album came out in 1988, but in 89 they released this song. And I think nothing encapsulates the sound of Guns N' Roses better than this song, which is called Paradise City. And brilliant track. I think mainly written by Axl Rose, and I think it was Duff McKagan helped him out on this one. Duff McKagan was the bass player. I watched a news programme the other week, and he was on there, and he was telling me about his life and the excesses that he went through, and he's got his life back in order now.
Oh, I've gone through some excesses in my life, mate.
Well, Axl Rose now, Simon, is the lead singer of AC/DC.
Is he?
Yeah, Brian Johnson's had to retire because they've told him if he carries on, he'll go deaf. So, but talking about Guns N' Roses, they were reaching a point where they were probably the biggest rock band on the planet.
Yeah.
And when this track came out, I think it was in the spring of 89, I think it got in the top 10 in the UK, but everyone bought the album, which is called Appetite for Destruction. I think that got to number one in 89. Great track. Now, there's a few people I want to dedicate this to. All rockers.
Yes.
Jed Galbraiths, who was sat with last night at the game.
Yes, and he had a big smile on his face when he came out on the ground.
Yes, and Jed, he goes to all the concerts. He's going to watch Rainbow in Glasgow, obviously, because the MEN Arena's shut. He went to see Kiss the other week.
Yeah.
So, but also to Bob and Gaz out of the workshop, this is Guns N' Roses and Paradise City.
Take me home.
Paradise City by Guns N' Roses, going out there to Bob, Gaz and Jed.
Next song, staying on the rock theme, well, it's not really a rocky song, but this lady, I class her as the Queen of Rock.
I must concur with you there, Noddy.
And I don't care anybody says, in her prime, there was nobody could touch this lady performing. As a dancer, she was just phenomenal. Talking about Tina Turner. Now, Tina Turner had been around since the 60s. She earned most of her fame with her husband, Ike Turner. But Ike was a... he was a control freak, and he's... But you've only ever heard Tina's side of the story. Ike denies a lot of what Tina said, but...
You get very bitter, these women, at times, Noddy. from past experience.
But Tina, in the 60s, was... A story about this, quite interesting, was... During the shows, Tina... And let's be honest, Simon, she could move.
Yes.
She was an absolute stunning dancer. Now. Well, in the 60s, Ike and Tina were supporting the Rolling Stones.
Yeah.
And Mick Jagger used to...